I want.
Let's see.
Yes, a pregnant cat did jump in my window, but she wasn't the first cat. It was the middle of the night in August of 2019. I heard a very faint meow outside. I opened my window and I saw a baby kitten. She was about 6 weeks old. So she was sick. I didn't see any other cats, no mama cat, nothing. I picked her up, brought her to the vet the next day. We've got her eye fixed up. Instantly, I introduced her to my two dogs, and she was absolutely fearless. And that was the first cat. I named her Etta. Fast forward a year later, there was a pregnant cat that we couldn't catch. She had her babies in the garage where they lived, and they stayed warm. I took one of her babies. That was Lulu. Then cats number 3 and 4. One morning I woke up and I saw her in one of the cat beds. I couldn't catch her. I let her jump out the window and I kept my window open just in case she came back, and she did. She was pregnant, but incredibly skinny. She was under a lot of distress because she was pregnant more times than not. Fast forward again, I had 4 cats, 2 dogs in tow to a new apartment. There was another cat there. Just one. Started to feed her and her 2 babies, and I was going to catch her and get her sterilized. A couple days later, she disappeared. And she left her 2 babies with me. They brought 2 more friends. Yeah, 8 cats. That's how I got 8 cats and 2 dogs. Here, the exciting thing is that I built a catio.
I started the area for the permanent catio. It'll be here. There's the back of the house. Well, I've got all of the walls cut. Front wall, back wall, and side walls cut. Now I just need to put on the stain. Okay, I have the beams up and I'm starting to put the supporting structures here. What I did this morning, I stained the door, and you see I've got the roof laid on, and I put, it's called freeze blocking, so these extra little pieces of wood, because there was a little gap. So no kitties can get out on this one. And then I'll do the same thing on the other side after work, so. Okay, I sealed up the roof. So that's covered and that's good to go. I put the door on. and I put the stuff on the front. I did the floor yesterday. Jojo, come on! And this, I have some cat grass seed in there, so hopefully that'll grow soon. And yeah, putting on that door by myself was a little tricky, but I got it. And I have the first thing latch here. So this worked on this side here for this one. And I'll just put a string through here and then I can pull it. And then I have a lock with a locking mechanism I'll put on later. So yeah, that's done. Not too shabby. I put some tree branch that was cut off. I don't know when. Found it, so I put this in here. Let's take a look inside. I have my pole secure to put on the sisal and some platform here. Here's a sleeping area and a walkway here and some other platforms here. Some, and then this one that goes up there. There's more I want to do, but there's a platform here too. There's more I want to do, but I'm a little anxious to get the cats in here today so I can finish up the project. So what I need to do now is put on the rete, the cage, on the outside here. Put it on the outside here and then build the tunnel.
This is how I live in Umbria, with 8 cats. Oh, and 2 dogs, and 2 dogs. Hopefully in the future, more animals. We'll see, we'll see, we'll see, we'll see. All right, until next time. I'll see you soon. Thank you for watching.